Guys, welcome back to LoadRunner Advanced Sessions. So unfortunately my system got shut down due to low battery, so I am continuing remaining session. So sorry for that. So now we are at result setting. So before running any test, make sure you enter results. So smoke test and enter the date when you executed. So today's date is 17/12/18. Okay, so likewise, and enter the name, and you can click OK button. Okay, so click save and click on start run button. Okay, so when you click on start button, it is automatically moves to run, and it is giving some error. So due to something, so let's see what error, because I have to open server. So it is saying connection to load generator failed and two-way communication error. It is unable to open the load generator name. So we'll see what is the error. Okay, so sometimes you will get this kind of errors. You have to resolve them. So see, if you see here, I don't have any localhost one. So that is the reason I clearly know that I did not have any load localhost one. So that is the reason it has failed. And let me go and change to localhost, because there is no localhost one. So that is the reason it has failed. Okay, let me save and let me run one more time. It should fail one more time. So it is asking you, whenever you forgot to change your results, it will prompt you the message. There is already results with for this test. Do you want to override them? If you want to override, say yes. Yeah, for now I want to override, because it doesn't matter for me, because it did not executed well. So the test went to fail status, so I am going to keep same name. So now the users went to run state, again they failed. This time I know, see, you can see lot of failed errors. So all of them failed at opening URL. Why? Means the server is not up. So that is the reason. Let's go to errors and see. It is saying there is a correlation function user session did not found and failed to connect to the server. This is the one of the error you will get frequently. Sometimes in interviews they will ask you what kind of errors you are getting. Okay, this is the one error you have to say. Failed to connect to server, connection refused, means there is no server is available. That is the reason connection is refused. Okay, this is most common error you will get most of the time. Okay, sometimes connection timeout also will get. Due to connection timeout in load generate, in load balancer, they will give some connection timeout. If your request cannot be made within that time, it will fail. Okay, so this kind of errors you will get. Just I wanted to show the errors. That is the reason I did not start my server. Okay, I will go and start my server now. So now my server is ready to take the calls. So now what you can do here is you can do reset. So all fail status to, it will go to again reset down status. Now you can see all my users are in down status. Two are in grayed out, because they are disabled in design state. That is the reason you are seeing grayed out ones. You can do two ways. You can either click on start button here, or you can go to run tab and you can click start scenario here. Either way is fine. Okay, whichever you are comfortable, you can do. If I click this way again, it will go to automatically this run state, run tab. Okay, if you click here, it is again asking me, do you want to overwrite? Yes. See, now it moved to run tab automatically. Now what it will happen is, it will go to pending and init and ready, and it will go to run tab. In run tab, what it is really doing is, we can see here. Okay, go to users and right click. Oh, it is completed before I did that. Okay, so anyway, we'll see later. Now see, if you see this, if it is passed, it will go to pass status. If it is failed, it will go to fail status. Okay, now all the users failed to failed status, and I want to see how many pass scenarios and everything. So there are four iterations. So it is trying to, first it went successfully first iteration, when it went to second iteration it failed. So because second time it went, tried to login opening the URL. Let me go and see what is the reason. It is saying webbridge find is not found. Okay, so that means it is not able to load that page. Okay, you can see which step and where it is failed. See, it is showing at the step 48. If you want to see exactly what is 48 step, click on this, automatically it opens VueZen for you. Okay, if you click here, it will opens the VueZen, and see, it is opening the load virtual user generator, and it will directly goes to that particular step. Okay, with all details. Okay, this is good learning because we are getting multiple errors, right? So this way we can learn lot of errors. Okay, there is one more error, we can see that also. It might be due to LG, might may say load generator is CPU utilization high on the server. So likewise you can get some error sometimes. It is keep on increasing, that could be the one of the reason. Okay, so it is VueZen is opening, so that is the reason my screen is not allowing me to do anything. So I will wait for some time until VueZen opens. So yeah, see, CPU usage on this load generator is exceeded more than 80%. So that is the reason my count is keep on increasing. Okay, so let's go here. So it is when it is trying to open this login session, it is failed. So the reason could be there is no test and PT in the application. This could be the reason, because due to wrong username it might have failed. Okay, so what I am going to do is, instead of going to all the users, I will make it sequential once. Means all users will take only one value. Okay, that is Jojo bean, so that there is no failures for my test for now. So now what I am going to do is, once anytime you get errors, try to fix them here. Okay, come here, save them and compile one time. And close your script. Now you made some changes to your script, that script has to update to your scenario. There are two ways you can do. One, save the scenario and try to reopen it, so that it will get, whenever you reopen it, the scenario, it will fetch the latest script from the that path. So if you open now, what will happen is, it will go and fetch the new script which you updated. This is one way. So why you want to do that? If you feel that is very hard opening and closing unnecessarily, then there is one more way. Select the script. There are details tab. Click on details tab here and go to refresh here and click script. That means what it does is, it will go to that particular script, it will get the latest script. Okay, whatever changes you made, that will be available now. Okay, so now if you want to see really the settings are updated or not, again go through details. Okay, yeah, here you can't do anything. So I am going to close this one. If you want to see changes, go to VUsers tab and select details here. Here you have parameter list. Click on that parameter list. If you see here, the username is changed to sequential ones, but still the password is sequential each iteration. So it always, password is always depends on username, right? So it should be same line as username. You can make changes here also. Okay, click OK. Now we made changes to that parameter settings. Okay, that way you can go and cross verify your settings also in through controller also. Some interviews they will ask, how do you change parameter settings in controller? Okay, select that script, go to view users and go to details. Go to details and click on parameter list, and you can see and change your parameter settings. Okay, still it doesn't change. Okay, save, click OK. Okay, so now if you want to make changes again, go to details and refresh your script. Okay, again it will fetch latest things. Okay, now again let me go here and see whether it is really changed or not. It should change, but some reason it is not changing here. Okay, some reason it is not changing. Okay, what happened just now? I changed. Okay, when I'm moving from one tab to other, okay, yeah, understood. Yeah, the main reason it is not changing is there is no dependency. See, this is separate, username.dat file is separate, and password.dat file is separate. If you are having both the details in single file, then only you can give sequential ones. It is actually both are separate files, it never depends on this username. So that is the reason it is not working. Here also I will make sequential ones only. Okay, so that this also will take Jojo, and this also will take Bean. So the problem here, what was the password.data is different, username.data is different, both are different files. That is the reason I did not able to give this same line as this one. Okay, so if both details are in single file, then only that option will be good. Okay, so now change it, click OK and close it. Now again I will cross verify whether the settings are happened or not. Okay, go to user script and parameter list. See, now password went to change to sequential ones. Okay, now the changes are good, we are ready to go. Okay, so that way whenever you make changes, go here and refresh your script. Okay, this is only way you can get the latest skeleton of your script. Okay, so this is one of the best option. Click run again. It is asking me to again check that one. I will say yes. Okay, override it. Now I will quickly show, if you want to see whether your script is really executing or not, right click here, go to view script. Now you can see that it went to again it is opening again load runner. Okay, anyway, meanwhile I will go to this one. See, here you can see there are total 3 users, 3 into 2 iterations, it is executed total 6 iterations. First time 3 users went and executed URL, again it went executed login, again it went executed log off. Then second iteration again 3 users went, so 3 into 2, 6 iterations. Ideally you should see 6 iterations in your all your transaction. These are unnecessary transactions. If you don't want them, I will show you how to remove them. So if you want to remove that action user, these 3 transactions which are coming extra, right, that is user end transaction, user init and the action transaction, you can remove them from going runtime settings. Let me show you quickly that one. Go to runtime settings. Okay, and go to miscellaneous, run each user as a transaction. You have to remove this. By default this will be enabled. Okay, you don't want each action to be a transaction, right? Anyway, already you are inserting load runner your own transactions, you don't want extra transactions. Okay, so if you want to remove that, best option, select this one. Okay, now click on save, and I am going to rerun it because every time I am overwriting it. So now again users are going to run state. I will quickly go this time and see, they are very fast. So user, this one, this is very important. Okay, here you can see which step it is performing. See, second user, the first user went to again this one, and it may enter username. See, this way you can even see. Don't do it for all the users. Whenever you want to see whether it is really opening and doing, you might be having a doubt, right, whether it is really doing or not. This way you can go and check it. Right click and click on show user, it will show you. While running only you can do, while stopping you cannot do. See, now there are no errors, there are zero errors, zero failed transactions. So that is the reason, whenever you see failed transactions, you have to see in VUGEN what exactly the issue is, whether it is parameterization issue, it might be correlation issue, or it could be different issues. You must fix them. That is the reason, due to parameter issue I am used to get errors, I fixed it. So now it will be pretty clear. Now I can see there are only three transactions. One is login, URL open, login, log off. You have to give always with proper name so that you will get them in sequence order. This is scenario name and step number and step description. See, three users into two iterations, I got each iteration 6 times. Okay, it executed 24 times, and running users currently 0, and hits it has maintained 5.4 hits, and total past transaction is 18. This is start scenario, this is reset, V users, this and all we will discuss later. Now once the test is completed, all users went to past status because there are no failures. If there is any failure, it will go to fail status. Okay, that is very very important. Only one time the users will go to past status. When is that? Is whenever you select run until completion. It always depends on runtime settings. If runtime is 1 or 2, that many runtime runtime iterations it will execute, and it will go to past status. If it is passed, everything is passed, then it will be passed. Otherwise it will be failed. If there is any error, it will go to error state. Okay, this is all about executing scenario. Here you have some graphs. By default you will get 4 runtime graphs. This is transaction response times. These are the very very important graph. You always monitor this graph only. Okay, running users graph, hits per second, and this is running users graph. How many users are ramped up, how much duration it is executed, you can see here. If you double click on this graph, automatically it will enlarge it and you can see bigger graph. If again double click it, it will become small. Double click. Okay, now I want to see like URL, what is the response time? See, and login, what is the response time? Logout, what is the response time? Like this you can see. Okay, so this is the way we can check response times. Okay, hits per second, you can see how many hits it has maintained. See, it has maintained 4.08 hits. Okay, these are all the graphs. There are many options, we'll discuss later. Okay, this is the way you can design the scenario, you can execute, and you can monitor response times. Mainly whenever you do load test or whatever test, mainly you will see this transaction response times. Sometimes during the test, client may ask what is the response time for this login scenario, so that you can come and you can take the screenshot and you can send to them. Okay, this is all about this one. Okay, so this way you have to design scenario, you can design the scenarios and run, you can run the tests. Okay, this is very pretty simple straightforward scenario. So we have seen today in basic schedule how to run until completion option. Okay, so that's all for today. Thanks for watching. We'll discuss remaining parts in upcoming videos. So thank you very much. See you in next session. Please do subscribe and let others know by sharing these videos if you do like them. Thank you once again whoever subscribed my channels, and so that I can do more videos. Okay, thank you. See you in next sessions. Bye guys.